Hey, what's going on, guys? Well, in this video from the vault, two classics with modern flares. Now, this is a video that was originally recorded in 2015. I found this on my external hard drive that I used to use a couple years ago with a bunch of other old videos that I never uploaded. Now, I believe I did not upload this video or any of these other ones because I felt they were poor or not done well. I think so. I reviewed this specific video. I think it's fine, but so I don't remember why I held this video back. I think I might have been one reason, because I sold one of these guns to a wackadoodle. So we can take a look at this video. So what I'm showing you in this video are two different handguns that I no longer own. The Smith & Wesson is on top. That's a model 627 8-shot with a 4-inch slab barrel. Very unique revolver. That revolver did have to go back to Smith because of a problem. I don't recall if I ever did a video about that. The cylinder would not open. It would be jammed up. So you would have to do a kick the door open malfunction drill, basically punching that cylinder out. So yeah, it was pretty bad. I sent it back to Smith. They fixed it immediately, really fast. I know they replaced like the cylinder, the hand, the ejection rod, and also the pin in there that holds the rod in place or something. So yeah, it was pretty bad. So brand new out of the box, that revolver did not work, but they made it right. Below that is a Colt railgun, an original railgun, not the beefed up frame. That one was 100%, and I believe I sold that to actually the revolver I sold to somebody at the range that I used to know, a public range. And the Colt railgun I sold to some random guy at a gun shop that overheard me talking about trading it in. And he kind of pulled me aside and said, "Hey man, I'll pay you cash." So of course that enticed me, but man, stupid. It was a big mistake. Sold it to him, and within, I think it was like 4 months later, he wanted his money back. It was just like that Les Bear I sold, where the guy was begging for his money back and he was blaming me. It was just such BS. Same thing happened with the Colt railgun. He said the thing doesn't work, jams, broken, and I'm like, "Sir, it's all sales final. Look at your bill of sale." And they get all stupid. "I never got a bill of sale. You never did anything." I'm like, "Oh my God." That guy, yeah, it turned out to be an issue, a problem, because he kept harassing me. Really long story. I do not want to go back to that time. So maybe we can do a story time on stuff like this, like selling guns privately. I've done it before, but I have a lot of stories about selling guns privately that they just get weird. I don't know. So that's the Colt railgun. I normally don't talk much about Colt. That was a good 1911. So before we get into this, I just want to say that, yes, I'm getting your emails, guys. I got like at least 32 emails, I think I counted. Everybody wants me to start talking about rifles and long guns, especially the AR-15 platform. So I am thinking this through. A lot of people want to see my post-ban registered assault weapons, as they're called. I have a Colt MT6400C that I got way back in the day. Still stock. It's been like, you know, that's a long time ago. I got a Stag Arms. A Ruger SR556 that I paid way too much money for, which is completely embarrassing because I bought it the day before our ban went into effect. I have a CAC SR15E3 that was built up by somebody, and a LaRue LTOBR that was also built up by that same gunsmith, if you want to call him, made him state compliant. So I'm thinking about, and I have a few more, like pre-bans and NFA. And so I'm thinking all this through. I think this will bring up a lot more new content, but we'll see. Let me think it through. Oh, and the 308 other everyone keeps asking me about. Yes, I will definitely do a video on that. All right, guys, let's check out this video. Here you go. Enjoy it and let me know what you think. Hey, what's up, guys? In this video, I want to talk about two classics with modern flares. What we see right here are two very classic type of firearms. Got the good old 1911 and the good old revolver, the wheel gun. Both of these platforms have been around for many, 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 many years. More so with the revolver, serving military and police alike. So they're proven firearms. You know, they've been around forever. They've saved many of lives and defended many of people. And I just thought it'd be cool to talk about this because in 2015, I think a lot of manufacturers are doing little different things with these two classic platforms, you know, giving them a little modern flares, as I like to say. So I figured we'd just talk about this. Now, these two specific models are by no means a good example of what else is out there, but let's talk about this. Basically, we got the Colt Railgun, and it's named the Colt Railgun for a reason. It's got a nice rail underneath there. You know, back in the day, seeing a rail on a 1911 would have been kind of very, very unique and different. I mean, back then we were drilling and tapping a Dawson rail on the bottom of a 1911 or doing some funky things to get a light or laser on this type of a pistol. Okay, so nowadays we got a frame with an integrated rail, which is pretty cool because you can put, you know, a nice light on there and utilize this pretty well. So that's why I say this is a modern flare to a 1911. I think the biggest thing is the manufacturing process. You know, we've come a long way, computerized type of manufacturing, a lot more precise parts are being made, materials could be different, you know, and stuff like that. I think that's the coolest thing about this stuff, like, especially with Smith & Wesson using that type of scandium alloy type frames, make them very lightweight. You know, a lot of people argue they would never use one because they think they're weak. To each their own, you know, to each their own. I think it all depends. But you got to weigh your options. But this Colt Railgun right here, I think, is a very modern type of 1911. It's extremely accurate, definitely. It's an extremely reliable 1911. I have put possibly 800 rounds of Winchester White Box full metal jacket through this without one single hiccup, failure, or any issue. So that's pretty good for a 1911. Day one, out of the box, it just works. Really great. And like I said, extremely accurate for a stock 1911. Granted, I probably only put 200 rounds of Win 1911 through this, which is that specific ammo, which I don't know how specific it is, made for 1911. I don't know about that. Basically has the you know, the silver tip style jacketed hollow point. I think they're called a Super X, which is kind of like an old school jacketed hollow point round, but it works, fed through this without a single problem. I mean, if you start looking at, you know, like Smith & Wesson's 1911s, those are, to me, a pretty modern type of 1911. I mean, if you want to go semi-custom, look at Nighthawk Custom, Wilson Combat. You know, those guys are doing a lot of different things with their 1911s. They're pretty cool. Pretty expensive, but pretty cool. And I just think that the 1911 is going to be here to stay. You know, they're still in use with law enforcement. I mean, I know of a quote-unquote SWAT team that uses the Colt Railgun as a secondary, which is, you know, a good testament to the quality and, you know, reliability of this pistol right here. So they're still in use. You know, a few law enforcement officers out there I talked to through YouTube, they carry a 1911 cocked and locked still with only 7 rounds in the magazine plus 1. So 8, you know, they're confident with that. They're fine with that. 45 ACP, I'm not going to complain about that round, but I like the 45 a lot. So I think this is going to be a, you know, the 1911 is going to be here to stay, and I think there's a lot of different things going on with them, especially with the 10mm. I think that's pretty cool to see some manufacturers creating 10mm in the 1911, especially Dan Wesson. I don't even know if they still do them, but I'd like to eventually get one of those. But this is the Colt Railgun. I think it has the modern flares on this. You know, just kind of just checking it out and showing it to you. It's pretty nice. I like it. This revolver right here, made by Smith & Wesson, is a, you guys know, 627 Pro Series 8-shot. And, you know, back in the day, 8-shot revolver would be unheard of. You know, maybe 7-shot, but when they came out with the 8-shot, that was pretty cool. I was like, really? You know, it kind of got me thinking. But anyways, this one right here, I think, has a lot of, you know, a lot of cool modern flares. As number one, it's an 8-shot, okay? And just the way it looks is, like, you know, cliche, not your father's revolver, but it's got a cool look to it, barrel profile, but that also hinders the holster for it, just because it's such a unique barrel profile. Good action, everything's smoothed out. It's pretty nice, except for the sights. You know, maybe they should put some night sights on it. This would be a pretty cool modern day revolver. And this one isn't probably the best example of a revolver with modern flares. I wanted to throw this in the video to show you a more modern revolver, like this one right here. I feel that this one's has more modern flares than the 627 Pro. Now, they're both cut for moon clips, and moon clips is nothing new. You know, moon clips have been around for a while. But what they've done here is they've chamfered the actual extractor. As you can see, they cut angles on the actual extractor itself. I've never seen that done by any other manufacturer or other gunsmith. I don't know if they have tools to do that, but they've knocked off some metal in each chamber, and that assists in reloading with a moon clip easier. This one has it as well, like I said. And I think that's a little modern flare right there. Now with this one, it has a little bit more because they've taken out the locking bolt. The locking bolt's right here. It would be right there. And they added a ball detent right there. And basically it locks up the cylinder tight and it allows it to move more freely. Another thing that's pretty cool is the barrel to cylinder gap is really precise. They're able to put this barrel in at a precise measurement and lock it in place. So it's held to much tighter tolerances, as you can see. So that's pretty different, and I think that's pretty modern. Other than that, the materials used to create this is scandium alloy titanium. It's pretty different. And if you want to talk about the M&P R8 and the Thunder Ranch 325, they have a light rail on the bottom. And the M&P R8 has I think you can add a rail on top. So the dreams of, you know, if you've seen Beverly Hills Cop 2 and Tango and Cash, you can put one of those huge laser sights on top of one of those revolvers. But anyways, so I just kind of wanted to talk about the modern flares of these revolvers. Like something like the M&P R8 is pretty interesting. Thunder Ranch 325, that's another interesting revolver. Those are being actually, I just learned, utilized with certain SWAT teams. I had heard about the M&P R8 being utilized with SWAT teams, but never the 325 Thunder Ranch. Someone on YouTube actually told me about their sheriff's department, their SWAT, the Shield Man, actually utilizes 325. You know, Thunder Ranch, which is kind of interesting to me. So that's pretty different. So revolvers kind of still in use with law enforcement. You won't see them in use with military, but they're still out there in the law enforcement fields. You know, and I do know a few law enforcement officers that do still carry revolvers. And I think what Smith & Wesson especially is doing with the different materials they're using to build these things and the concepts, like my pug nose, I think that's pretty forward-thinking and very modern. So I just kind of want to show these two guns to you guys, classics with modern flares. What other ones would you want to put up there that are like classics and modern? I know a lot of people were talking about that Chapada, is that how you pronounce it? Rhino? A lot of people are asking me about that model. I personally don't have any interest in it, that type of a revolver. I've shot one before at the range. I don't know. What do you guys think? Name some of these like classics with modern flares. I'd be curious what you guys think. All right, guys, that's about it. As always, stay safe and check 360 often. Later.